got to get sugar out of your life.
Hello everyone, it's old Butter Bob, and I bet you never thought you'd see a video with me and this sugary stuff. But I've got these props here today to tell you about an experiment. A simple experiment that was done to show how easy it is to make your liver fat. This experiment, which I'm going to show you the name of right here, they deliberately overfed these people about 1,000 calories of sugar a day, every day for 3 weeks. And I couldn't get exactly what they had, but I got pretty close to what they used in this experiment. And they used some pineapple juice, they used some soda, and they used the equivalent of what we call in America a gummy bear. These little gummy bears, they're little rubbery, sugary bears. Gummy bears. Anyway, I've tried to measure this out to be exactly right, so it'd be about 1,000 calories. And got about 17-ounce Pepsis. I've got 75 gummy bears, and that's about exactly right for 30, 40 calories. And I've got 2 8-ounce cups of pineapple juice. That's about 260 calories, and the Pepsi's about 420 calories. Anyway, it adds up to right around 1,000 calories of extra sugar per day.
So these experimenters, they overfed these people about 1,000 calories a day for about 3 weeks. And the result was that these people gained about 2%. They got overall 2% fatter than they were before. But here's the kicker, folks. In just 3 weeks' time, their liver got 27% fatter in just 3 weeks' time of eating 1,000 extra sugar calories a day. And I think from just the things I showed you, it's not that hard to eat 1,000 calories of sugar a day. Now, let's put this in perspective for a minute. If they gained about 2% body fat overall, but their liver gained 27%, that represents about 10 times more weight gain, more fat gain in their livers than in their overall body. 10 times more fat. But believe me, folks, this liver fat is really bad. It might be the first step towards heart disease, diabetes, and even getting fat. Now, here's another thing that happened in this experiment. Their triglycerides increased an average of 50%. You know, people wonder about where triglycerides come from. They get a test back and my triglycerides are high. Folks, this experiment shows you, if you got high triglycerides, more than likely, you're eating a lot of sugar. And another thing that happened in just 3 weeks' time of overeating this junk food, their HDL cholesterol decreased almost 3%. And you know, one of the most important numbers you have to tell your risk of a heart attack is your triglyceride number divided by your HDL number. In other words, if your triglycerides are high and your HDL is low, that ratio is probably going to be bad. And if it is bad, that's a very good predictor of whether or not you're going to have a heart attack in the future or some heart-related event. Another important thing that happened in just 3 weeks' time is their fasting insulin. You know that background insulin that I talked so much about in my video, Fasting and the 50% Insulin Problem? That's the insulin I'm talking about. This background insulin that keeps you fat. Well, in just 3 weeks' time of eating too much sugar, eating an extra 1,000 calories a day, a couple of Pepsis, some juice, some gummy bears, or maybe just a Little Debbie snack cake, or two, or three, or five, well, that insulin number, that fasting insulin number, went up a whopping 34%. In other words, it raised a third higher in just 3 weeks' time. So just in 3 weeks' time, the liver fat goes up almost 30%. Triglycerides go up almost 50%. And your fasting insulin goes up 34%. Just eating too much sugar every day. Now, I'm going to tell you something else about the study. Do you remember how I told you that fasting every other day for 3 weeks can make you 7 times more sensitive to insulin? Well, guess what? In just 3 weeks of eating too much sugar, these people became 26% less sensitive to insulin. In other words, they were making 34% more background insulin all the time, but their body was 26% less sensitive to the effects of insulin. That's 26% more insulin resistant. You know, when you get a blood test, have you ever got one of those cholesterol tests or a blood test and they show all your numbers? They have cholesterol, they have triglycerides, they have liver enzymes, they have AST, ALT, GGT. And these liver enzymes tell doctors if you have liver disease or if you have liver damage or you have something going wrong with your liver. And guess what? In just 3 weeks of eating and drinking this junk food, that one of those enzymes, the ALT, went up 28%. And the GGT went up 48%. I know these numbers sound like just so much medical mumbo jumbo, but what they really mean is in just 3 weeks of eating this junk, a test would quickly show you've got a dramatic increase in the enzymes that tell doctors how unhealthy your liver is. You know it matters what you eat. So many people write to me and say they've been diagnosed with fatty liver, non-alcoholic fatty liver. But they forget about the non-alcoholic part. They just hear the fatty liver. Many of them say, I have fatty liver, but I'm not a drinker. I don't drink, or I drink very little. Because everybody knows that alcoholics are likely to get fatty liver. But very few know that sugar, the sugar used in everything that we eat, our processed food, is actually made of two types of sugar. I know you've heard this before, but really hear me on this. About half of the makeup of sugar is glucose. And the other half is fructose. That fructose sugar is processed in your liver. That's where it goes after you eat it. And in higher amounts, it's bad for your liver. And I mean, it's really bad. It makes your liver fat. Dr. Robert Lustig has called fructose, that sugar that we've been talking about, alcohol without the buzz. Fructose causes your liver to get fat, like alcohol. But unlike alcohol, fructose doesn't give you a buzz. Doesn't get you high. It just slowly but surely makes you fat and sick from the inside out. You know, Dr. Lustig has a very interesting line in his article of his called Fructose, Alcohol Without the Buzz. He says, what do people on the Atkins diet and traditional Japanese people have in common? Well, you would think they wouldn't have much in common, but they do. The people on the Atkins diet shun sugar. They don't eat sugar. And the people in the traditional Japanese diet don't have sugar. One is a very low carbohydrate diet. One is a very high carbohydrate diet. But the one thing they have in common is they don't eat sugar. And neither should you. Your body can only store about 1,500 calories of sugar at a time. And believe me, if you eat a standard diet, you already have this much sugar stored in your body right now. After the 1,500 calorie limit is met, your body has to do something with that sugar. And you know what it does? It converts that extra sugar into fat. That's what it does. It converts that sugar into triglycerides. You know that triglyceride number you see on your cholesterol test? That's coming from all the extra carbs you've been eating and drinking. That's where it's coming from. Your liver converts all that sugar, that extra sugar, into liver fat. You know, it's in the liver that this sugar is converted to fat. And since all that sugar converted to fat is made in the liver, it tends to stay there in the liver. As the liver gets fatter, some of that fat spills over into your blood. Some of it begins to clog up your pancreas too, the place where insulin is made. Professor Roy Taylor from the UK has done research showing how the increasing fat in the liver spills over into the pancreas, eventually leading to type 2 diabetes. I wrote a little article about Professor Roy Taylor, who is a personal hero of mine, and it's on my website, and I'll link to it. Professor Taylor's work is very important, and you need to read about his work. I have many links in my article and links to several videos that he made, and you really need to see them. All this fat created from sugar that you eat, also causes your insulin levels to rise. This higher insulin level also makes it easier to create fat, and much harder to burn the fat you create, and the fat you already have stored around your belly and your butt and your chinny chin chins. About a year ago, I made a video about the whole complex tree of insulin-related diseases. I call it drying up the root, but I've changed the name recently to high insulin, the root of the tree. Anyway, in that video, I pointed out that type 2 diabetes, heart disease, non-alcoholic fatty liver, high triglycerides, and obesity are all related diseases. They're branches on a big tree with a common root called chronically high insulin levels, or what doctors call hyperinsulinemia. As you can see in this video, your liver getting fat is related to your triglycerides going up, and your HDL going down, and your weight going up, and your insulin going up. They're all related. And as Professor Taylor's work shows, all this fat spills over into your pancreas, eventually causing type 2 diabetes in some people. When you go to the doctor and find out you've got one of those problems, don't be confused anymore. All these problems can be greatly reversed or made much better by simply changing your diet. There's nothing wrong with medicine, but this is a too much of the wrong food problem. And if you want to fix it, you need to change your food and change it today. Listen, guys, if you don't listen to anything else I say, if you don't care anything about my high-fat diet idea, if you don't care about fasting, you don't want to do anything that I've ever said in any of my videos, there's one thing you ought to do. You ought to get sugar out of your life. You ought to get it out. You ought to make sugar something that is so rare that maybe once a year at Christmas you might have some. Sugar is a poison. It just is. Throughout all of human history, people did not eat sugar. They had carbohydrates. There's no doubt about that. I won't deny that. But they didn't have sugar. You've got to get sugar out of your life. As I do with all my videos, I always write them out for people who would rather read them. They'll have links and things like that you can follow much easier than a video. And hope you'll visit my website at www.buttermakesyourpantsfalloff.com. And especially read that article about Professor Roy Taylor. It's very good. And there's a short video in there that I took from his much longer lecture. And it basically breaks down how your liver gets fat in 5 minutes. It's fantastic. As always, thanks for watching. Bye-bye.